Marches against gun violence will be taking place in hundreds of cities this afternoon, with teenagers taking the lead. Many traveling to Washington overnight to call for action on gun control.
But gun control is a heated topic in this country, as we said. Not everybody believes restricting guns will make schools safer. ABC's David Wright is at the main rally stage in Washington for the march today with a look at what both sides are saying as we head into today. David, good morning.
Good morning, Dan and Adrian. A very chilly morning here in Washington. But today, this is ground zero in the national debate about guns and schools. Pennsylvania Avenue, the Capitol, right behind me there, the White House just a few blocks that away. Hundreds of thousands of people expected to converge here, led by survivors from Stoneman Douglas High School.
They're here from across the country, hoping to send lawmakers in Washington a powerful message.
It's terrifying going to school every day knowing that there's a chance that a shooter might come in.
I think this is going to be a real moment of change. I'm, like, honestly fed up.
This group came all the way from South Florida, some of them hitching a free ride on a jet donated by the New England Patriots.
We may be like a target, like next.
A like-minded local family is putting them up. Their host, sick of worrying about gun violence in schools.
I have the greatest guests ever. I've got six kids in my house, three girls, three boys from Jacksonville, Florida.
Many celebrities are tweeting their support, including Oprah Winfrey, Miley Cyrus, and Justin Bieber. Already there are signs that lawmakers are getting the message.
Our voices are loud, our voices are clear, and our voices are about to change history.
But there are also loud voices on the other side.
Well, we were disappointed to hear some of the president's comments.
Gun rights advocates believe the answer is more firepower, not less.
We protect our president with guns. We protect our congressmen with guns. We protect banks with guns. But when it comes to schools, all we do is put up a sign that says gun-free zone, and it's not working.
Plenty of lawmakers agree, but today these marchers are hoping to convince them otherwise.
Students are stepping up to take on the NRA because our elected leaders are afraid to.
America, we are your future. Why won't you protect us?
Now, this event here in Washington is the main event today, but there are events all across the country and around the world, frankly. This movement spreading far and wide. The organizers say 835 local events planned in all. Dan and Adrian?
Will it have an impact? That's the question. David Wright, thank you very much. For more on that very question, let's bring in David Hogg, who is one of the organizers of this march. David is also a survivor of the shooting at the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. He's in our Washington bureau this morning. David, good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So I want to start by showing you a number from a recent ABC News Washington Post poll. When we asked people whether they thought the spate of mass shootings in this country were a reflection of problems with our mental health care system or inadequate gun control laws, 57% said mental health, only 28% said gun control. So in light of that, what specifically are you hoping to achieve today?
Today we are going to start a revolution. This is the beginning of a lifelong marathon, not only for me, but for my generation. We are sick and tired of the inaction here in Washington and around the country at different state capitals and in different cities, of politicians that are owned by the NRA and not listening to their constituents in the future of America. We are the children. We are making our voices heard, and we will change America with or without these politicians. And today is the beginning of that revolution.
David, Dan and I both had the chance to speak with you and so many of your other students in Parkland, Florida and Tallahassee about this movement. And a big slogan was never again, never again allowing another school shooting to take place. What was the feeling? What was the gut reaction when the shooting happened in Maryland earlier this week?
I had to relive a lot of the previous memories that I had from my school shooting. Everybody takes grief their own way, but for me, it was more infuriating realizing that because that was a person with a gun, and in reality, were they taken out by law enforcement? Yes, and I'm so glad that they were, but they shouldn't have had to do that in the first place. It's due to a lack of in-training, a mental health care problem, a gun control problem, and an American problem is what we have here.
David Hogg, we appreciate you joining us this morning. We appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's get some analysis now from ABC News chief political analyst Matthew Dowd, who's in Texas, and Republican strategist and ABC News contributor Alex Castellano, who's in Miami. Gentlemen, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it. Matthew, let me start with you, and then I'll turn to Alex. This is such an emotional and seemingly intractable debate over guns in America. Do you think today's march is actually going to move the needle?
Well, Dan, all social movements over the last 100 years have been led by the energy of the youth combined with the mentoring of the older generations, and I think that's what you're seeing here. We've already seen some change. As everyone knows, Florida passed a ban on certain age limits on guns. The president's reaction in banning bump stocks, all of those things are in the aftermath of the high school students standing up and giving voice. And I think today is another step in that process. And as David said, they're not going away. They understand it's a marathon. They understand it takes a long time. Today's just a big energy boost for that movement.
Alex, do you agree, especially given the poll numbers we've shown already that show that many, many Americans don't have an appetite for stricter gun control?
Well, I think these students are going to have an impact. It's going to be a modest impact in terms of actually making schools safer, unfortunately. We are seeing, you know, schools being hardened, locking doors, perimeter security. Those are the kind of things that we don't do now that we could do. But as far as actually, you know, we already have a lot of laws against killing people. We have background checks, and very few of these laws are being enforced against the mentally ill having gun. So, you know, we're not enforcing what we have now, but we're going to pass more laws not to enforce. The big impact is going to be political. 2018, the women's movement, the Me Too movement, add that to the Dreamers, immigrants concerned about Donald Trump and the wall, then add these kids, millennials, voting for gun control and Democrats in 2018. You've got a big Democratic wave coming. That's what's going to change.
You know what, Matt, I've got to switch the storyline, though. We're going to continue this conversation over guns. What is the most meaningful thing that could come out of the Stormy Daniels storyline? Aside from the tabloid details, what could come out of this?
Well, we've seen a lot of suggestions from Stormy Daniels' attorney that there is evidence or there's information, and obviously everybody's going to be tuned in for the 60 Minutes interview, the first time she's given a long-form interview on this. And so I think it's both a political and there's a legal question. What do they have legally that they can prove out a lot of this? But from a political perspective, one, it's putting much stress on the president, both in his professional life as president, but I'm sure in his personal life as a husband to Melania in all of this. And so I think what we're going to see come out of this is, one, we'll see the evidence, what evidence there is, but two, it continues to put unbelievable stress and time constraints on the president of the United States.
And Alex, of course, a lot of Republicans think this is more of a sideshow, and many of them are growing weary of this. What's your take?
The idea that, you know, is this going to have a political impact on the Trump administration? I doubt it. You can't fall off the floor. You can't burn down the same house twice. Donald Trump's is not regarded well by Republicans and his supporters because of his moral turpitude. He's there just because he's an alternative to two bankrupt parties, Democrats and Republicans, who are out of control and can't lead the nation. So he is useful. He is not a moral symbol. I doubt this is going to change the political equation, but it's going to be the the Super Bowl of 60-minute interviews.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people still think this is considered another witch hunt.
Right, and well, for sure, it is something that a lot of people will be watching, no question about it. Matt and Alex, we appreciate your analysis on a Saturday morning on this day when we have these marches and as we head into the Stormy Daniels interview tomorrow night. Thank you again.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.